Let us find out what is the Laplace transform of this trapezoidal function. And for that, first of all, let us find its mathematical expression. So up to 0 to 1, if you see this function, then it is nothing but the ramp function with slope is equal to 1. So we can say that for this time period, this function is equal to RT, where this RT is the ramp function. Now during the time 1 to 3, the slope of this function is equal to 0. So we can get that by adding a ramp function at time t is equal to 1, which has exactly opposite slope of this RT. And mathematically, that is equal to minus R of t minus 1. Now during the time 3 to 4, the slope of this function is equal to minus 1. So mathematically, that is equal to minus R of t minus 3. And now, from the time 4 onwards, the slope of this function is equal to 0. That means at time t is equal to 4, we need to add a ramp function which has exactly opposite slope of the minus RT. So mathematically, that is equal to R of t minus 4. So by adding these 4 ramp functions, we will get the mathematical expression of this trapezoidal function. So let's say, if this trapezoidal function is equal to x of t, then this x of t can be given by the summation of these 4 functions. And now, if you take the Laplace transform of this x of t, then it can be given by this expression. So as you know, the Laplace transform of the ramp function is equal to 1 divided by s square. And using the time shifting property, we can say that this R of t minus 1 is equal to e to the power minus s divided by s square. And using the same property, we can also find the Laplace transform of the subsequent ramp functions. So now, if we take this 1 divided by s square outside, then this is the Laplace transform of this trapezoidal function.